Welcome back to another video, and today we're going to talk about the much awaited topic of NFTs. So by the end of this video, you will hopefully be able to understand what NFTs are, what drives the price of these NFTs, how to buy these NFTs, and is there actually any real world application to these NFTs or no. And let's talk about how wild these NFTs are going. NFTs are being sold for millions and millions of dollars on the blockchain. Kids are making hundreds of thousands of dollars selling JPEGs, and this is something in the history which has never been done before. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Aryan, and let's talk about NFTs today. So to get started with, you should know that NFTs stand for non-fungible tokens, and the fungible part in this means interchangeable. So the best example to put this is, for example, there's a student going to college and he will have his own unique ID card and his ID number. And whatever marks he gets is recorded on his ID card. So at the end of his engineering or whatever course he's doing, it is not possible to interchange those values of his marks to another person's ID card, right? So if I get some GPA, it is not possible for me to tell the college that, okay, this is the topper and he got 10 GPA and I want that GPA. So that is not possible, because the ID cards in this case are not interchangeable. So it's non-fungible here as well. So another good example to put this would be game skins. So a lot of you might have played games like CSGO, or we have Fortnite, and a lot of these games have gun skins and character and avatar skins. So these type of assets in the digital world are a real good example of what NFTs could be. And since these are assets, since I'm calling these assets, there is complete independence of these assets to be sold on a secondary marketplace. So for example, if I hold a rare or a legendary skin in a game, I could list this skin on a marketplace and demand money for it because of the scarcity of the skin. In a similar fashion, NFTs are these assets, but on the blockchain. And the distinguishing factor here is the wallet address with which you hold these NFTs. So we just talked about how the student has a college ID card and that is unique to him. In a similar way, on the blockchain, when you're transacting and when you're buying NFTs, the NFT is held on your unique wallet address. And that is how it becomes unique and non-interchangeable. And this, in the most basic sense, is what NFTs are. And these days, there are audio NFTs, video NFTs, but the most popular ones are the JPEGs. So one major question which I get a lot is that how is there any real world value to these NFTs? So of course, the utility and the applications of NFTs differs from project to project, but let's go over some major projects which have taken the NFT space by storm. This is CryptoPunks, and this is a collection of 10,000 unique characters. This is one major part where the scarcity factor comes into play and drives the price of the NFTs. So this is a game of basic demand and supply. So once all the 10,000 unique pieces are sold out, people have an option to sell it on secondary marketplaces where they could sell it for prices higher than what they bought it for. And that is how the price increases and increases and increases. To understand how the value really goes up, you could compare NFTs to something like gold, which is very limited in supply. And you know that once all of the gold on earth is mined, the demand will really go up. And similarly, in NFTs, after a project is completely sold out or as it is selling out, the demand goes higher and people are comfortable about selling it for higher prices than what they bought it for. So this is CryptoPunks, and you would be shocked to know the prices of these NFTs, these pixelated NFTs. And let's go through a couple of more projects, and then I'll show you where these NFTs are bought and sold and how you could do it too. So this was CryptoPunks. It's very basic, it's pixelated, and it has a lot of hype behind it. And this hype factor is something which we'll talk about more. Bored Ape Yacht Club is one of those projects which have bought in real world utility in their own way. So the real world utility factor differs from project to project, as we just talked about it. But what they are doing special is that the members of the Bored Ape Yacht Club, or basically the members who hold these NFTs, have special perks in the real world. The Bored Ape Yacht Club in this case has real world applications where the holders of the NFTs could annually meet in a club, a real place, a hotel in Miami, if I'm not wrong, and they could interact. So the main part which you have to focus on the real world application here is that if you hold a Bored Ape Yacht Club, and if your favorite celebrity holds a Bored Ape Yacht Club, say Cristiano Ronaldo holds a Bored Ape Yacht Club, and you hold a Bored Ape Yacht Club, you guys are connecting in one place, and you get the opportunity to network with Cristiano Ronaldo or be it any other famous artist. And so basically, it brings in that opportunity of networking for you, and you are in the same zone as the other person. And that's really where the hype factor comes into play. You might have seen celebrities and athletes buy these NFTs, and their fan bases jump right into these NFTs just because their favorite person has these NFTs. And by human nature, you would not want to FOMO, where you have an opportunity to clearly be in a surrounding or be in contact indirectly or directly with your favorite sports person or an athlete. So you get the basic point of it, right? So where could you buy and sell these NFTs? Well, there are a lot of options now, but the major place to buy and sell NFT remains to be OpenSea. This is OpenSea, and it runs on the Ethereum network. So one of the main problems with the Ethereum network is that the gas fees is a lot, the transaction fees is a lot. So if you were to go and buy an NFT, there would be a lot of transaction fees, and that's why people are shifting from Ethereum to other networks these days. But OpenSea is one of these places where you could buy and sell NFTs. So let's just quickly go through the two projects which we just scanned. So these are the CryptoPunks, and let's just randomly click one and see what prices they went for. So this CryptoPunk was sold for 27 Ethereum, which roughly equates to, so one Ethereum is around $3,200 right now. This was 27.49 thousand dollars in rupees. That would be 66 lakhs. Somebody bought this picture of a pixelated bald person with a mustache who is brushing with a headband for 66 lakh INR. And that is the scale of hype you can imagine on the NFT marketplaces. This is the Bored Ape Yacht Club, and there are 10,000 pieces. And the floor price, which is nothing but the base price of these NFTs, is 68 Ethereum. And mind you, these NFTs did not start off with these prices directly. The Bored Ape Yacht Club specifically was at 0.08 Ethereum when it started minting, which means that when they were not sold out, you could initially buy it for 0.08 Ethereum. And as you can see, the early holders, the early believers of the project are rewarded the most, be it NFTs or cryptocurrency. But the real question is that how could you get into these NFTs right now at this point of time to make such massive gains? Well, to be honest, it would be really speculative to pick an NFT project, a new NFT project, and say that it would 100x or 1000x over a long period of time, because you don't know when the hype factor could kick in, right? So it is really speculative. The NFT market is a hype bomb, and it could boom anytime, and it could also blast down anytime. That is it for now, and in the next videos, we'll be talking about how you could get on early in these projects, which are coming up in the market real fast, and also which ones could you invest in. So stay tuned for that, and let me know any questions which you have in the comment section below. That is it for today, and thank you for watching.
We shooting for stars. Wallahi wallahi, wallahi wallahi, wallahi wallahi, wallahi wallahi, wallahi wallahi, subhanallah, subhanallah, wallahi wallahi, wallahi wallahi, wallahi wallahi.